Hi everyone. I hope you're all doing okay. I just wanted to say I realized I was getting more. I'm getting more subscribers. So I think when I started my first video, I had like one or two subscribers, and now I have 23, which is amazing. It's amazing for me. Yeah. So because I've got some subscribers now. First of all, I just wanted to thank you for subscribing, and also I'm guessing that the reason why you've subscribed is because you would like to know more about Sjogren's and that you're suffering too, or you know someone who is, and I really hope that I can help in some way. And I don't know about you, but for me, even just watching somebody who has a chronic illness on YouTube makes me feel better. I have to say, some are much more active, physically active. There are some who are not, and I like to see both combinations because, well, it all comforts me, and the ones who are more active kind of give me hope, and when I'm having a really rubbish day or the whole of the year since last March, I'm just comforted by people who weren't doing that well because I could relate, and I found people I could relate to. Anyway, say all that, what I wanted to say was that if there's anything that you would like me to talk about on my channel, if there's anything you would like me to talk more about, investigate, basically what would you like to see from me, what would you like to see from my channel? I'm doing this for myself because it makes me feel good to talk about my symptoms and my journey with chronic fatigue, my journey with Sjogren's and fibromyalgia. So that's my part, but then the other part is, since I have a channel and subscribers now, I'd like to help as well with my videos. So anyway, thank you so much for being here, and I'm sending everybody a big hug and lots of love and comfort. So the reason why I decided to do a video today is because I just wanted to say hi and update you on what's been going on with me, and also tell you what I think, another thing, a main thing that I think has helped with my chronic fatigue. Now, saying that, I think this has helped my chronic fatigue, but it doesn't mean that it has. I think chronic illness and what we have, I think it is a bit of a mystery, and I think that nobody is the same. So for some people, some medication will work, for some people, supplements will work. People do studies, and not everybody gets a result from a study. So just saying what has worked for me. So since March 2021 till March 2022, I have consistently had chronic fatigue. Now, maybe it has been okay for a few days, for a few weeks on and off, but when I say it was, maybe it's been okay, it hasn't been fully okay. Like, my body has always felt this heaviness. If you have chronic fatigue, you know what I mean. I've had that since last March, and it has been a new thing for me. A few years ago, I don't know, maybe 5 years ago, I had it for a little while, but that was more, it wasn't as, the feeling was not as bad in my body. It was just, I was very stiff to move, I couldn't really walk, and then they put me on steroids, and I was like fine within 2 days, which is not the case anymore. Anyway, so in March, when I had a video saying how I didn't make going on my trip to America, after that, I really crashed. I had the worst time, was in bed. You can see, like, I think, I don't can't remember what it's called, but 2 videos before, you can see I'm talking about taking Plaquenil, and I can hardly catch my breath because I'm just so exhausted. And I looked at a video by Dr. Jin Sung. I saw his video about thiamine, vitamin B1. And he was saying how much it really helps with energy. And I knew that with chronic fatigue, doesn't matter how much. And I didn't think that it would really help my chronic fatigue. What I thought was maybe it will just help my well-being in general, and that might make my chronic fatigue or any illness just a little bit better, just a little bit more comfortable. But then I decided to Google about thiamine, vitamin B1, and see if there's anything that there is about thiamine and chronic fatigue. And I found quite a few things. I'm going to put links down for his video about vitamin B1, part 1 and part 2 he's got. I'm going to put a link for a few articles I've seen. I haven't read through all of them, but I'm just going to put them in if you guys would like to read through them and also do your own studies, obviously. But I'm just going to find, this is the first thing I saw, and after that I was like, right, I'm going to try this. Sorry, I have a little bit of a infection, so I'm on antibiotics, and it's for my nose, and it's just bothering me, but so excuse that. Thiamine may be the missing link to treating autoimmune disease and autonomic dysfunction. Although deficiencies in this vitamin have long been considered eradicated, case studies show supplementation with this nutrient improves fatigue in autoimmune patients in a matter of hours to days. I was like, what? And it's not going to work for everyone. And I don't know if this is what has worked for me, but I'm just putting like my timing together. Why all of a sudden, after a year of having chronic fatigue, I start taking thiamine? And let me see where it is. And I didn't, look, these are all the different supplements, but, and I didn't, where is it? Here it is. I never like to take anything in large doses. I mean, in one of the things I'll send you, I think there was a study and, you know, they tell you to take 1,000 milligrams of this and that. And that kind of thing scares me. I feel like I always want to start with the smallest measurements. And also, I just want to see how it goes and do things slowly. In general, medication has always been the way that it affects me stronger than maybe another person. I always feel like I need to take lower doses. And with all vitamins and minerals, you know, you have to make sure that your liver and your kidneys and everything else are coping. So anyway, I took this. How do I show this? I'm filming on an old iPad, so I'm sorry about, I wish I could afford a, what's it called, a vlogging camera. Maybe I will. So yeah, it's only 100 milligrams. I started taking it every day from, I guess, sometime in March. It didn't work straight away, like hours or days from when I started, but maybe a week, 2 weeks. I started getting better and better, and I mean, with my chronic fatigue, and I felt, like, one day I woke up and I was like, oh, that feeling in my body has gone. I feel like my old self. It was amazing. And I was like, oh my God, how long is this going to last? Is it going to last a few minutes, a few hours? And it lasted. But what I did do in that time was still pace myself. I wasn't going to be fooled into thinking I'm okay and just go and be like doing everything and running around and crash again. So I did everything. Even when I felt fine, I would stop. Say I went out for an hour and I could have stayed out for 3 hours. I came back home. I thought, let me just save that energy maybe for the next day. And we know that doesn't work. Even saving the energy for one day for the next day doesn't really work. Sometimes it doesn't matter how much energy you think you've saved. The next day is unpredictable. But that was my mentality. I thought, let me try. And I have to say, touch wood, I have not suffered from chronic fatigue for I don't know how long now. I said it in my last video, and I'm still okay. I think it is this, because look, I mean, they've had these studies. I don't know if it will work on everyone, but I just wanted to just mention it, because long as you know you talk to your physician or you do your own research, and you feel good with your own self, please don't ever just take my word for things, because this is about what works for me. It may not work for other people, or it may something else might work for somebody else and not work for me. So anyway, just wanted to share that. Yeah, give it a go if you want. Please give it a go and let me know how you get on. And please start with the lowest dose. Okay, maybe not the lowest, I don't know. I'm on 100 milligrams a day and it's worked for me. Of course it could have been somebody else, but I'm keeping on taking it. And I have to fill this in, but I have started taking a lot of different supplements. But the few that I was taking before didn't make any difference. And this, since taking this, it has. And since I knew this was working, or seemed to be working, I added other things. So I know it's not the other supplements, it's this that has given me, made my chronic fatigue better. Of course, when your chronic fatigue is better, your mental thinking is better. And they definitely are correlated in my experience. So I'm going to wrap it up. I always think that I can talk about a lot of things, and I realize that all the time is, it's a lot of minutes for you guys to listen to. I don't want to bombard people. But I wanted to show you toothpaste and eye drops and eye masks and talk about all sorts of things. But I will leave them for the next video. And yeah, just to tell you what I like to use and what I feel makes me comfortable, even down to like socks. I mean, I'm not at all promoting anything here. It's just my stuff and my experience. Yeah, so if you are happy to leave a comment, please leave a comment letting me know what you're suffering with or what has worked for you or what hasn't worked for you, whatever you want to say. And also let me know what you would like to get out of my videos. What would you like me to talk about? Or are you happy with the way I'm just carrying on as I am? Sending everybody lots of love. And yeah, wishing you a great day. It is a rainy day here in London, but it's kind of cozy. Thanks so much for watching. I'm sending everybody lots of love and see you next time. Bye.